Hello students, I am teacher Svetlana. In our previous lecture, I have already explained about the operon concept. In this lecture, we will see about the lac operon, which is also called as the lactose operon, and the role of lactose in the cell, which is covered in the chapter Molecular Basis of Inheritance. So let's get started. The lactose operon or the lac operon. Lactose or the lac operon of E. coli is inducible operon. The operon is switched on when a chemical inducer, lactose, is present in the medium. Inducible means you require a small substance which will induce or start the functioning of the operon. Lactose operon consists of the following components. These are the following components present on your lactose operon. The regulatory gene, also called as the repressor gene. You have a promoter gene. You have an operator gene. You have a structural genes, and you have the inducer. Now, this inducer is required by the operon, but it is not a component or a part of the operon. Let's see each of this in a little bit detail. The first one, the regulatory gene, also called as your repressor gene. Have a look at this diagram here. This is your regulatory gene. This gene controls the operator gene in cooperation with an inducer present in the cytoplasm. The regulatory gene always precedes the promoter gene. So you will have a promoter region. Before that, you will have the regulatory region. It may not be present immediately adjacent to the operator region. Regulatory genes produce a protein called as a repressor protein. So these genes produce a protein which is called as a repressor protein. This repressor protein goes and binds to the operator region and it represses or stops its action. And hence it is called as a regulatory protein. Next, students, we have the promoter gene here. Now this is located just adjacent to the operator region. The promoter gene marks the site at which the RNA polymerase will come and bind. So, when the operator gene is turned on, the enzyme moves over the operator gene and transcription. It will move over this operator gene and transcription of this structural genes will start. Promoter gene base sequence, that is this base sequence here in the promoter region, that sequence determines which strand of DNA acts as a template. Students, the next component is the operator gene, which is located just adjacent to your structural gene. When the operator gene is turned on by an inducer, the structural genes produce an mRNA. So these structural genes will produce an mRNA only when you have the operator gene, which is turned on by an inducer. Operator gene is turned off by a product of the repressor gene. The next component is the structural genes, which is located here in your operon. When lactose is added, in case of our lactose operon, when lactose is added to the E. coli culture, the structural genes catalyze or produce mRNA, which in turn produces polypeptides on the ribosomes. The polypeptides form acts as enzymes to catalyze lactose in the cell. These are three structural genes. In sequence, we have LacZ, LacY, and LacA. Enzyme produced are beta-galactosidase, beta-galactoside permease and transacylase respectively. So this is the entire structure of our lac operon. Then the next component is the inducer. As told earlier, this is not a part of the operon, but it is required for the functioning of your operon. It's a chemical in the cytoplasm which inactivates the repressor. So this is your inducer. This is the repressor which normally goes and binds to your operator region and does not allow these structural genes to be transcribed. But what happens when this inducer is present? It blocks the repressor and now this repressor cannot bind the operator and the operator region is free. So when the operator region is free, the RNA polymerase can easily bind here and transcribe these structural genes. So this chemical acts as an inducer. So in case of lactose, operon, the lactose molecule acts as an inducer. Students, let us have a quick look at the working of the lacoperon. There are two situations possible. One is in the absence of inducer and another situation is in presence of the inducers. First, let us have a look at what happens in the absence of an inducer. You have your operon. You will see first is the regulatory gene region, then you have the promoter region, then you have the operator region, and then you have your structural genes. Now here 1 to 3, this are three genes which are having information for the productions of three different enzymes which are required for the metabolism of lactose into the cell. So in absence of lactose, which is your inducer, what happens? The regulatory gene on transcription gives your repressor mRNA. This repressor mRNA on translation produces a protein which is called as the repressor protein. Now what does this repressor protein do? It straight goes and binds to the operator region. Once it has bound to the operator region is blocked and the RNA polymerase cannot come and bind to the operator region, due to which these structural genes cannot be transcribed. So in absence of lactose, the genes of which are required for the production of the enzymes that are going to be required by the cell, bacterial cell, to metabolize lactose will not be formed. So this is the entire scenario that happens in the absence of an inducer. Now let's have a look at the scenario that happens in the presence of an inducer. We have the same lacoperon here. You have your regulatory genes, your promoter region, operator region, and then you have the three structural genes that are there just immediately after the operator region. Now you'll have your regulatory gene as usual. In on transcription, it will give you the repressor mRNA. The repressor mRNA on translation will produce the repressor proteins. Now, what is happening in the presence of the inducer? This inducer, that is our lactose, this comes and binds to your repressor protein, due to which the repressor is now inactivated. Since it is inactivated, it does not move and bind to the operator region. So the operator region is free for the RNA polymerase to bind, and hence it will allow the transcription to proceed and these three structural genes will be transcribed into the mRNA. Later on translation, it will give proteins. Now what are these proteins? The enzymes that are required for the metabolism of lactose. Which are these three enzymes? Which are these three genes, students? Let me tell that first. You have LACZ, LACY and LACA. Now what are these producing? Beta-galactosidase, beta-galactoside permease and transacylase. What are the functions of this individual protein, student? Beta-galactosidase, it digests the lactose into galactose and glucose. Beta-glycoside permease, it allows the entry of lactose into the cell. And transacylase is required for the transfer of an acyl group from acyl-CoA to glycosidase. So basically these are the three enzymes which are required to metabolize lactose as a source of energy for the bacterial cells. So this is how, in the absence of lactose, these genes are not transcribed and the enzymes are not produced, and in presence of the lactose, these genes are transcribed and the proteins or the enzymes that are required for the metabolism of lactose are produced. So this is how the operon works. Students, let us quickly have a look at the role of lactose. Now, obviously, lactose is an important component in the working of your lacoperon. That is, the operon functions only in the place when lactose is available, as lactose acts as an inducer. Now, a few molecules of lactose enter into the cell by the enzyme permease. A small amount of this enzyme is present even when the operon is switched off. Now, a few molecules of lactose act as inducers and bind to the repressor. This repressor inducer complex fails to join to the operator region, which is then turned on. So, if we have a look at this image again, we will see what the repressor and the inducer does together. They form an inducer repressor complex, and the repressor gets inactivated, and that repressor cannot bind to the operator region. So this is what the lactose does. As the repressor now doesn't bind to the operator gene, the structural genes produce all the enzymes. Does lactose act as an inducer for its own breakdown? So basically for its own metabolism, lactose itself acts as an inducer. When the inducer level falls, that is the level of lactose falls, the operator is blocked again by the repressor. So the structural genes are repressed and inactivated again. So this is called as a negative feedback. So the moment the level of the lactose falls down, then you have the repressor is again free to go and block your operator region, and the structural genes are again repressed and there is no expression of the structural genes. So this process is called as a negative feedback mechanism. So this is how the lactose operon operates, and the main role that is played by lactose itself for its own breakdown or utilization by the bacterial cell. So lactose is utilized as a source of energy when it is present in the surrounding medium of the bacterial cell, of course. Students, this is a simple image for a quick recap of how your lactose operon works and what happens when the lactose operon is off and on. Now, when is it off? When the inducer is absent, that is when our lactose is absent. You have your repressor or the regulatory genes producing your active repressor. This repressor simply goes and binds to the operator, and the transcription RNA polymerase cannot bind to the operator region, and hence what happens is this three genes are blocked. They are not transcribed. These are those three genes which are required for the productions of the enzymes that are required for utilization of the lactose. I have put them here. What each and every individual gene is for, which particular production of which particular enzyme. In presence of your inducer, the lactose operon is considered as on. That is, you have your active repressor which is produced. Inducer, that is your lactose, now comes and inactivates the repressor by binding to it. The RNA polymerase can bind to the operator region now since it's free, and the transcription proceeds. And all the this genes are transcribed into the mRNA, and the mRNA on translation will give you these three enzymes which are required for the utilization of lactose. Thank you, students, for participating in this lecture. We will meet soon again with the next topic. Till then, take care, be safe, and keep learning.